Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to be able to participate in this Luxembourg Internet Days. I would like to share with you, my short speech, which would indeed focus on the new cybersecurity strategy. Maybe we could move to the next slide. That gives you a little bit of a background, context in which we have been all collectively living. What we have been observing over the last few years was that our critical services, being in provision of energy, transport, they are becoming, increasingly digital. We have really skyrocketing number of connected objects. Cyber attacks are on the rise. And I think for us collectively, the experience of pandemic was indeed an unprecedented lesson in accelerated digitalization, but that also actually meant our vulnerability to attacks has been widened. In that context, we found particularly disturbing, the attacks on our health system. Apart from that, obviously we have a situation where cyberspace become increasingly the space of geopolitical context. It is also increasingly seen as a new military domain, and in the world that is, I would say, less predictable, less familiar to the one that we used to live, I think this actually raises the stakes enormously. The foundation and principle for our action in the area of cybersecurity is basically understanding that we cannot be successful in digital transformation, we cannot have trust of citizens and businesses if we don't get cybersecurity right. The strategy that Commission adopted at the end of last year was an attempt indeed to give a comprehensive, holistic narrative and a plan of how we can actually crack this challenge. So we can go to the next slide, which actually gives you, an overview of how this basically strategy is composed. It has various elements related to Europe's technological sovereignty, our capacities, our international dimension, and last but not least, also making sure that we walk the talk and we as the European institutions are also cyber secure. We have different instruments, of course, regulations, funding, and different domains, and I will tell you a little bit more in detail in the following slides. So we can jump two slides further. Excellent. So this is the first pillar of the strategy, which is very much built around, the notions of resilience, sovereignty, and leadership. The minister actually mentioned baseline cybersecurity legislation, NIS directive. We are indeed, the Commission in December last year proposed, the new directive amending the current regulation. I think we are basically, taking it step further, if not two steps further, covering much larger part of economy and coming with new ideas, which would help, to achieve our basically goals of having stronger cybersecurity. We have new provisions on crisis management or coordinated vulnerability disclosure. And as I have said, we are covering much larger part of the European economy, including public administration. So basically we will have many, many companies across the internal market which would have to take cybersecurity measures and report serious incidents. I will not go into all the elements of the strategy, but let me just highlight a few. We are making a major investment in developing the network of security operation centers that can actually help to proactively scan and detect emerging threats and attacks. We are taking further steps to complete implementation of the 5G toolbox on cybersecurity, where basically member states decided jointly, to really tackle this challenge, making sure that the new generation of mobile telephony that was basically is a backbone of the whole new range of digital services, including such things like autonomous driving, is really conforming to the highest standards of cybersecurity. We will actually invest seriously in cybersecurity, so we have the highest amount ever in the multi-annual financial framework, but we also have significant investment in cybersecurity in a number of national plans of recovery. And the minister also mentioned indeed this initiative of the Commission, which is the competence center and network, which is about to pull the research. This is just taking off the ground with the center established in Bucharest and basically the corresponding coordinating centers across all member states. Without joint investment, without joint deployment of top-notch cybersecurity solutions, Europe will not be able to be competitive. And then, of course, skills, cybersecurity skills, both, let's say, at the low end, you know, skills of the users, basic skills of the users, but also cybersecurity skills of professionals. This is something where, indeed, we need to invest collectively. And by the way, you know, clearly, one thinking about, let's say, promising career, I think one of the best policy choices, sorry, career choices for young people, indeed, is to consider becoming a cybersecurity professional. So we can go again to, we can skip two slides. So we go to the second pillar of the strategy. Excellent. So I was describing to you different investments and policy actions, which are very much related to resilience. We also are looking into the issues of our capacity to respond to major crises. Commission came up with the idea of a joint cyber unit. I will explain this in a little bit of a moment. We have a range of measures on cybercrime to basically complete cybersecurity union agenda. Among them, for example, is the new amendments to the pillar of the International Action Against Cybercrime, that is the Budapest Convention. We have also a very important investment in fight against cybercrime done collectively with EC3, European Cybercrime Center at Europol, and national cybercrime units. As strategy is a comprehensive document, we are, as I was saying, we are very much covering also the international dimension. And within that context, the Union has at its disposal, you know, so-called cyber diplomacy toolbox, which is basically about our collective capacity to respond to state actors which are, you know, trying to basically, you know, attack us. And from that point of view, we need better intelligence sharing. But ultimately, you know, thanks to the cyber diplomacy toolbox, we are in a position, for example, to make a joint political attribution to basically condemn action of certain third countries which are responsible for particular attacks. And again, following this whole logic that we need to have the same tools that we have in relation to the offline challenges, that we are also collectively as Union able to impose sanctions. And this tool is being increasingly used. And in this strategy, we are coming up with new ideas, such as, for example, considering a qualified majority for taking this type of decisions. And finally, we have also plans related to development in the area of cyber defense. The issue of cyber defense has been very prominently featured in the State of the Union speech by the President of the European Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, in September, where also in the context, you know, of the global challenges, we are, and she has been speaking about, you know, our path toward secure, toward defense union, and of course, in the global context, connected world, we cannot have a credible defense posture without properly covering cyber component. The next slide will give you a snapshot of what is the idea of a joint cyber unit. Basically, it is about making sure that we can have an effective collaboration between different cybersecurity communities. and that ultimately we are able at a European level to coordinate our response to a major cyber attack. Touch wood, by the way, so far we have not had such an attack, but as a recent wave of incidents demonstrate, attacks on critical infrastructure with a very tangible kinetic effect are no longer the question of future or science fiction. They happened, and as the attack on Colonial Pipeline in the US has demonstrated. So coming up with this initiative, which actually was for the first time raised in the political guidelines of the Commission President when she was about to take the job, the steer of the European Commission. So we have been, in this analysis, we basically see that we do not have sufficient cooperation between different cybersecurity communities. We also would like to have a full possibility to use to engage with private sector, and all of this, of course, is potentially difficult and complex given the legal institutional constraints that we have. And by the way, working across different communities is also challenging at the level of member states, given that you are talking about different distinctive mandates of various communities. In terms of objectives, the ultimate objective is our capacity to provide a coordinated response, and that requires preparedness and common situational awareness. When I'm referring to the two communities, we mean, first of all, of course, the civilian community. By civilian, we mean, of course, like national cybersecurity authorities, we mean national CERTs, and we mean, in a way, also the cybersecurity posture of private sector, which has its own security operations centers, its own cybersecurity specialists. Then the second community is clearly law enforcement, those who actually are very much engaged in identifying, cyber criminals, pursuing criminal investigations. Thirdly, it is our capacity to project our interests in this domain internationally. It's our diplomatic response. We see more and more that we have diplomats which are basically specialized in cyber affairs. And last but not least, of course, the defense dimension of cybersecurity, which we again also see at a rather early stage at European level in the work of the European Union military staff and European Defense Agency. The way to get to this idea of a platform for cooperation, of course, would be only incremental. We are now in a sort of preparatory phase, working and discussing things with member states. We have recently, so the Commission has adopted recommendation on the Joint Cyber Unit in June. Last month, we have the, let's say, formal response of the Council about this initiative, which are very happy because indeed this is an initiative of a major importance, and we need, let's say, a common take on this and ownership from member states. So let me just maybe move to the last slide. Again, let's flip two slides forward. Excellent. And, just to conclude, as you see, this integral part of our cybersecurity strategy, which was actually adopted jointly by the Commission and High Representative of the Union for Common Foreign and Security Policy. So within that context, we are notably calling on and presenting practical measures how we can actually promote EU leadership on international norms and standards. I think notably from the point of view of competitiveness of European industry, of European cybersecurity industry, it is important that we are really part of the game when it comes to setting, the international standards. Cooperation with partners is of utmost importance. We have cyber dialogues with a variety, with a number of countries around the world, with primarily, of course, like-minded countries which share our, let's say, values and fundamental approach to internet. But of course, we also have to engage with those who have different approaches to cybersecurity. And EU is very active also in the international fora, coordinating, our positions, in the context of the United Nations and other international organizations. And finally, we are also taking measures to increase global resilience and capacity in terms of you know, working also with other regions, with developing countries, as basically with all regions of the world digitalizing, we are definitely interested in, let's say, exporting our ways of effectively responding to cybersecurity challenges, which are very much also about respecting our fundamental values, about respecting privacy of the users. So with this, again, let me thank you for the opportunity to address the Luxembourg Internet Days. And I would also say that we, you know, we are generally very closely collaborating with our colleagues from Luxembourg. Luxembourg is quite active in various, let's say, initiatives in this domain. And last but not least, of course, our colleagues which work on, let's say, digital affairs, many of them indeed are based in Luxembourg. So again, thanks a lot for this opportunity, and I wish you a successful conference.